Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and in this video, I'm going to show you guys an exciting new membership update that is going to knock your socks off, and a little hint, it has to do with your own customizable themes. So, let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Okay, so I'm really excited about this update, guys. This has to do with membership themes inside of Hi-Level. So I'm gonna show you guys how to create your own membership themes. So step one, you want to go into your products. So go to sites, memberships, and then products. And you're going to click on the course that you want to adjust the theme for. And you're going to choose the theme. So step one is choose the theme. And you're going to have several options here to choose from. And if you don't see that real quick, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to go into the settings on the account and click on labs and then turn on product themes. So we're gonna turn it on. And then we can also submit feedback in here after we try it out. So let's go back to our membership area and go to products and click on your course and click on customize. Now we can see the themes. Yay! All right, so they only have a couple to choose from here, but that is okay because you can actually customize this and make it your own. So let's just click on this one and we can click on customize. And step two, we're gonna customize our theme. All right, there's a lot of different choices here. So I'm just gonna show you like what the colors are assigned to here. So the primary color applies to the button, top icons, lesson, progress, course title, category title, lesson title, and instructor title. The secondary color applies to instructor name, description, lesson description, category description, and button text. The primary font applies to the button, top icons, lesson, progress, course title, category, lesson title, and instructor title. Secondary font applies to these things, and the logo placement decides if the logo will be placed in the header or the hero section. So let's go ahead and start playing here. And I'm gonna change my color to my blue color. And then I'm also gonna change my secondary color to green. Let's do a green. Then I'm also going to change my font. And I can change my background if I want also. I'm just gonna make it gray. Then we're gonna click on save changes and see what happens. Ooh, nice and ugly now. Yeah, but at least we know it's working. And then you can decide on the logo if you want to put it in the header or the hero section. Not sure what I just did there. Oh, here we go. Header, you can choose the background. Hero section, you can choose the background. Lesson progress. So you can even get more granular with your colors or your fonts if you don't like what it's looking like, okay? But overall in my theme, I'm gonna leave it like this. Okay? And then you're gonna click on save theme, and it says that it went ahead and saved the theme. So that was step three, save your theme. If we go back into the gallery and click on my themes, no, that doesn't show up. Let me refresh it. Okay,
So let's see if it saved anything here. So it looks like it did save it. It just didn't update the little preview image. But it did save my theme here. And it looks like once you click on Save Theme, the changes are stored for the theme in the account and not globally. But if you click Save Changes, the changes are locally. If you click on Save Theme, then they can be saved for global use. And the Save Theme only saves the latest changes stored after Save Changes are clicked. So if you click on Save Theme and you haven't actually clicked on Save Changes, so Save Changes is, you can't see because my face is in the way. Save Changes is actually down here. So you have to click that first before you can click on Save Theme, or else it's not going to save anything that you just did. So that's kind of super important. And then if you click on Save Changes on a theme that's not applied, then it's not going to update it globally. So you have to click on Apply Theme also to do that. And then a little added bonus, if you want to change the instructor details, fav icon, and logo, you're going to go into your product in the course and click on Edit Details, and then click on Customization, and you'll be able to change the instructor, add the headshot, instructor name, instructor title, instructor bio, also the logo image and the fav icon image of your membership area. And if you don't see this, this customized section here, you may have to go ahead and refresh your screen, go back out of it and go back into it and refresh it again. That's what I had to do to get it to show up. So I hope this helps you guys to add themes to your membership area. Let me know in the comments if you're planning on doing this and what you want your theme to be. And don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me. And I'll see you next time.